Every year, the DNR seeds Iowa's rivers and streams with more than 250,000 trout, spawning and raising each animal from harvested egg to half-pound fish a year later. It's an intense process that requires a great deal of patience and skill.
Well, the DNR is stocked with specialized and time-tested professionals. That interest had to start somewhere. Well, for one very special group in Charles City, the next generation of aquatic wildlife experts are just starting to dip their toes in the water of animal husbandry.
It looks pretty close to 8, and you can kind of put it up here.
I think it might be like a 9 or 10.
This is our trout in the classroom release day. There's 22 students all together. I've got a conservation club that we meet every single day, fifth hour. I've got a group here that elected at the beginning of the year to take care of the trout. They were interested in it. They were passionate about it. And then I've got a group here that I meet with on Friday mornings at 7:30 called my fly fishing club. All different groups all come together for this one day, and we're doing some water tests this morning. We release the trout, and then later on we'll have a chance to do a little bit of fishing too.
They're really small.
Yeah, I don't see anything, do you guys?
Few people are foolish enough to call fishing easy, but reeling in a fish has nothing on the hard work it takes to raise and release adolescent trout.
Oh wait, right here. It's another larva thing. Right now we're sifting for bugs to know how well and healthy the water is. And so like based off the certain bugs that you find, that's how you can tell if they're able to live in this water, if it's healthy enough, or if there's certain bugs in here that can like stand pollutants, then it's not that healthy of a river. But right now we found some bugs that are very sensitive to it. And so since they're in here, that means that they can withstand that.
Release day is the grand finale of a semester's long journey for these students. It's a journey students across the country take every year with the guidance of the fishery-focused nonprofit Trout Unlimited.
Trout in the Classroom is actually a project that was started by Trout Unlimited. Iowa Driftless Chapter up in Decorah was the ones that donated us funding to be able to bring the kids here today. It's been supported by them to purchase the tanks, so it's been a good partnership.
And the tanks in Charles City Middle School is where this annual project begins.
Back in January, we received about 250 eggs from the Iowa DNR. So they're always our partner in Trout in the Classroom.
This is the size trout that we stock.
So ever since that time, the students have been raising the trout. And they get to watch the different life cycles from, they start out as eggs, of course, and then they become a leaven. It looks like a tadpole in a way. And then they take on the fish appearance that you see when you typically think of a trout.
And when the right spring day arrives, it's moving day for the trout.
We are taking the trout out of the tank that we have been raising them in, and we're putting them in this bucket so we can take them out to Spring Creek by Orchard and let them go.
The next one is going to be Streamflow. Go to page 425 in here. This one's really fun.
While certainly a day full of adventure, release day is packed with learning. It starts off with all kinds of water quality measurements, using everyday tools and a few things you're probably used to seeing in chemistry class.
Basically, you stick this down in here and break off the tip.
Oh.
And then it'll fill with water. And then you kind of shake it for a little bit and then hold it.
Wait, in where?
No. Blow it there, and now you let it fill.
Oh, it's turning colors, okay.
And then you take it out, and kind of just go back and forth some.
Trout require a very sensitive, they're very sensitive in terms of the water quality. It's very evident here in Iowa and other trout streams around the country. The pH has to be right on, the nitrogen levels have to be right on. And so through that, they learn what a sensitive environment it demands. A couple other things we talk about are land ownership. We talked a little bit about some of the governmental and conservation efforts that take place up here to make a trout stream like we have here in Orchard a great place to fish.
And nearly all of the Trout in the Classroom students are avid fishermen. But taking part in this event is about much more than an excuse to cast a line during the school day. From the very beginning of the project, students are expanding their minds on what it takes for these animals to survive.
Just getting them in the first place was nice, just to see the cute little tiny eggs. And then we also want to learn more about, like, just the things that you can do to help out with stream and fishing and everything like that. It really shows you just, like, how much humans can impact fish, even nature.
And I really think it's helping our community, because it's teaching, like, the next generation how to take care of your stream and find out if it's unhealthy for the animals living in it.
Of course, when all the measurements come in clear, the main event takes place. And while pouring buckets of young trout into a creek might seem anticlimactic, Ryan is quick to point out this was never about the destination, but rather the lifelong journey.
I think it gives a greater respect to the different entities that have to come together to create a place like this for trout to live. It takes a cooperation between private owners, the government, being the Iowa DNR, and then anglers themselves, of course, too.